What are the effects of Bantu migration in Kenya? The Bantu dispersing from the area around present-day Cameroon from 3000 BC to 500 AD had massive cultural, technological, economic and environmental impact throughout the Great Lakes region and in East, Central and Southern Africa. The area was not entirely empty, but was populated by other peoples who were hunter-gatherers while Bantus were farmers in moist, wet forested environments. Farmers, unlike hunter-gatherers, are able to produce enough food to feed themselves and store surplus harvest for use during lean periods. Farming dictates settling in a particular location for a long period, unlike hunter-gatherers who have no settled communities, but rather move about and settle briefly on those locales where food is plentiful. Due to the food surplus resulting from farming, there was more division of labor and specialization in other areas, and that is why its Bantus are the ones who came up with iron smelting and forging technology, a process of great complexity. This process, I must add, was unique and completely different the process in Europe. By 1000 AD, Bantus using iron had changed the landscape, transforming large areas of virgin forest into the kind of forest in which human intervention is visible. This, with the sharply rising population of Bantus, pushed the original hunter-gatherers into smaller and smaller enclaves deeper into the forest. This caused the decline of original hunter-gatherer populations and certainly completely decimating some. Today in Kenya and Tanzania, the original hunter-gatherers are collectively known as Ndorobo, a derogatory umbrella term comprising of over 17 distinct groups in both countries. Today, the process of expansion of Bantus into areas originally occupied by Ndorobo continues, and Ndorobo women snatching is common, especially as reported in Tanzania. Under increasing pressure from the more numerous Bantu, more and more Ndorobo are taking up farming and settling down into villages. Another impact of Bantu on the original hunter-gatherers was outright assimilation into Bantu population. This can still be traced today through clan names and names of individuals. Of course, there was trade between the hunter-gatherers and Bantus, as well as intermarriage, though later was marriage of Ndorobo women into Bantu tribes, which further shrunk Ndorobo populations. There was also technological exchange, especially in beekeeping, arrow poison, hunting skills and wild survival skills in the drier environments the Bantus expanded into as their populations grew further. I have a healthy interest in the history of my tribe and have been able to map out how they migrated from Tanzania, through Gates to Veta to Kilungu and onwards to Machakos before coming into contact with Maasai and Nkikuyus. Old men who are almost all now gone tell of how the land we have settled in was occupied by small, thin hunter-gatherers who were very skilled in hiding and hunting.